Well, this is one of those trading days that just almost wear you out. I mean, the market is really not going anywhere, but it's just kind of vibrating around and not really accomplishing a whole lot other than it does have kind of a lower tone. Let's take a look at what's going on in the corn market right now. It chops back and forth. Right now, it's on a downward leg, and we have the December contract now 6 1/4 lower at 674 3/4. So now we're back within a penny of our low of the day and off of our overnight high by almost a full dime. So now the pendulum is kind of swinging to the downside here. Now on the soybean trade, you have November 7 1/4 lower. We're at 1364 3/4. That one is off of its overnight high by about 14 cents, but it's off its low by about 7 cents now. So that'll give you an idea of the gyrations going on here. January down 6 1/4 cents right now. Now, on our quotes provided by Bar Chart, let's switch to wheat. And in Chicago, we have December 5 3/4 lower at 843 3/4. Well, now that's almost on the low of the day. We're within a penny, or excuse me, within one tick of it. And now we're on the low of the day. There's a new one. 843 1/4, that would be down 6 1/4 cents. That's 19 cents off of our overnight high. So the wheat market flipping around and going lower today. It had been higher. Kansas City, December, is back to unchanged at 944 1/2. That's 16 cents off of its overnight high. What the heck is going on here? On Minneapolis wheat, you have December 5 1/4 higher yet at 961 1/4. And on our cotton, we'll go to December. It's, wow, down 359 points. Look out below. Now it's all the way down to 78.70 cents per pound. What happened to all the $1.20 and $1.30 prices we had not that long ago? Let's bring in Todd Bubba Horowitz of BubbaTrading.com and discuss. All right, Bubba, it's like somebody just threw that banana peel under the grain market and the crop markets here. But just for the last few minutes or so, what's going on? Have you heard?
No, there's nothing going on, Marlon. That's exactly the point. We're going nowhere, but we're getting there in a hurry. You know, you're just seeing a bunch of vacillating, churning around the mean in these markets. There's very little action. There's very little volume. There's very little to do, and it makes it tougher. And again, what's really happened, I think you're seeing some sellers trying to come in and push them down a little bit, and again, I think that will create a much bigger rally when they turn. You know, nothing has really changed from a fundamental side, and not that I'm a fundamentalist, but from a fundamental side, there's still going to be a shortage. There's still going to be a big demand. Strong dollar, no strong dollar, it doesn't really matter. People want to eat. And at the end of the day, I think we see some big movement. But until we get some volume and some action back in this market, it's going to continue to be this churn where they flip around back and forth. And, you know, right now they're all down across the board. In 20 minutes, they could all be higher.
Let's look at this dollar index. Right now, December dollar index futures, they're 571 points higher at 112.565. That has continued to be kind of a thorn in the side of the grain market.
I'm not as big a believer in that because, again, when we come down to a true demand cycle, there's not a lot of places to go and buy grain right now, right? I mean, you know, we know that, you know, the other competitors or other parts of the world had bad supplies. We've got that problem with Russia and Ukraine with a lack. So when it comes down to it, we're the place, we create the most, and we've got the most, and they're going to have to buy from us no matter what the dollar's priced at. And so at the end of the day, I think that, you know, it's. I don't think they're being affected by the dollar. We have to remember that the correlations between the dollar and grains, you know, what is the fair number? What is the fair correlation? And nobody really knows the answer to that because, of course, they keep pumping into the money supply. So it's an interesting problem, but the inflation is not interesting. It continues to rise at a rapid rate, and which is really making the dollar worth less anyways.
West Texas crude is 33 cents higher right now. The Dow futures up 30 points, pretty flat right now on the December futures there. Todd, great to talk with you. I appreciate the time.
Thanks, Mom.
Todd, Bubba Horowitz of BubbaTrading.com. We'll take a break. We'll talk livestock after this.